Hi, this is Aaron and Linda with Traveling Flamingo, and today we've got a couple of cruise news stories for you. First off, we're going to talk a bit about ship design and how they're changing with the needs for coronavirus testing on board. We're also going to be talking about whether or not this new news of the Pfizer vaccine changes your mind on cruising. And lastly, turns out that one of the first cruise ships that went to the Caribbean wound up having COVID. And so we're going to talk about that coming right up.
Let's start with looking at cruise design. As this year we've really been talking about a lot of health and safety protocol with cruising and how that is sort of affecting the industry. And so they're now looking to add COVID testing labs on cruise ships. And this is to ensure passenger, crew, and local health safety. And so now we are seeing it on the first cruise ship. The Viking Star cruise ship is going to have the first PCR, the polymerase chain reaction laboratory. I don't know if I pronounced that correctly, but either way,
I don't think it is.
The PCR, they're going to have the PCR testing laboratory, and this will allow for large scale testing that can accommodate up to 930 guests. And this will be a huge, I think, game changer, as we were talking last week with the requirements to have people test before they get on the ship. And if you've got thousands of passengers, how do you do that and keep the people physically distanced while waiting? So be able to test 930 passengers will be a big deal.
Yeah.
And the testing is pretty simple. It's just a swab that then tests for antigens. So the Viking Star is actually scheduled to make its first voyage in December of 2021, so not till next year. And they're looking at doing a 136-day world cruise, so that would be pretty...
Good way to kick it off, I guess.
Absolutely.
You're going to test it with a 136-day world cruise, I guess.
So, you know, I think it's promising, and it is looking at the long-term health. I think one thing that COVID has shown us with the cruise industry, I mean, it had been slammed prior to with sort of health and safety and how easy it is for infection to spread. And this is no joke. Everyone's taking it very seriously, and they want to make sure that's not happening anymore and people are safe.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, it's interesting because we had just talked about earlier these test cruises that they're going to be going on as well, and they're looking for volunteers, and it'll be interesting to see if things like this, you know, having the rapid PCR tests on board makes that easier and so forth too. So on to our next story. As you might have seen in the news, Pfizer's come out and said that their vaccine looks like it's 90% effective. They're obviously still crunching all the numbers. You know, I'm sure everyone's kind of jumping the gun on, you know, this vaccine. I've heard that could possibly be ready at Christmas to start being sent out, but who knows? Generally, though, you've seen a lot of positive response from this. So you've seen Norwegian Cruise Line CEO Del Rio, who's seen that a lot of people are starting to rebook on their future cruise credits. Sailings are going up again. The intent to buy is very much there. You saw this also in NCL, Carnival's, and Royal Caribbean's share prices. They were up upwards of 30% on the stock market. Same with things like Air Canada, the, you know, flight industry. Things are sort of kind of bouncing back a bit more with a lot of this stuff.
Yeah, unfortunately, it didn't last too long for the cruise because NCL then announced that they'd had their third quarter losses, and it did bring a slight drop back into the stocks. And Del Rio, he also pointed out that on Monday, the Food and Drug Administration authorized the Eli Lilly's antibody treatment. So I think that's also another positive step towards just tackling this COVID-19 thing in general. And recently, we also saw that the CDC did not extend their no sale order, but they brought in the certificate program. We thoroughly went through all the requirements and everything. So we have a video on that. Make sure you check it out if you're interested, because it is going to affect what cruising will look like, especially out of the USA. And Del Rio also said that NCL is planning on doing some trial runs in January. And so we're just interested to get, as Aaron said, some more information about what that will look like and how that will go.
It'll be really interesting getting the sample cruises from NCL. They seem to be one of the first ones with dates out of the gate. So, you know, we'll see whether or not that happens. But, you know, with the two vaccines, you've got the Eli Lilly one, you've got the Pfizer one. seems like there's more progress. There's the Moderna one also that's also out there or starting to be tested.
I also appreciate Del Rio's optimism.
Yeah.
He is hoping that NCL's full fleet will be able to resume in 6 to 9 months. So, you know, it's definitely not an answer, but it's the best answer they can give now. They feel like it's looking pretty promising worldwide. So, yeah. 6 to 9 months.
It's going to be interesting to see how they validate if you have the vaccine or what, right? It'll be just interesting what new procedures will be in place after the procedures they've already put in place to validate things like that.
Yeah, right? But do you have to, like, can you require people to get a vaccine? Ooh.
Well, places will for, like, when you travel to other parts of the world where you're required those vaccines to travel. So maybe just everyone's going to have to prove it somehow.
Let us know your thoughts on that below, because I, having discussions with friends and colleagues too, could see how that could be
difficult.
Mm-hmm.
So all of this connects to our final story today, and that story is about the SeaDream 1. We had talked about the SeaDream 1 in previous videos. Basically, it's a cruise ship. It's got about 53 passengers and 66 crew on board, so it's a much smaller ship. However, they were going to be one of the first ones to be cruising and going to ports in the Caribbean. So here we are, their inaugural cruise for this, and they have at least one case of COVID found on board. The captain notified everybody on the ship to quarantine, so everybody had to go to their cabin and quarantine. They're going to be returning back. And so, they were really excited to get into the Caribbean again. About a third of their bookings come from the Caribbean. The Caribbean is obviously very popular in general as a cruise destination. And so they have wound up having a case of COVID on board. And again, this was one of the first ones to start cruising. And so, you know, it's just not looking good in terms of, you know, cruise lines doing this. The big companies have come out with all these different processes and procedures, but, you know, as we'll talk about shortly, that doesn't mean a lot of them are following it, and, you know, they need to follow it.
Well, I think what the SeaDream did is they really relied on testing. So you had to, Barbados said, because the cruise left from Barbados, you had to have a negative test within a couple days of arriving in Barbados. So people arrived with a negative test. Then you had to get tested again before you got on the ship. So there's your second test. And then 4 days in, they were going to be testing you again. Even when they had gone to islands, they were not interacting with locals. So I think they were under the idea that they created this bubble of negative, you know, nobody's got it. So they did still have physical distancing, but they did not require masks for the first 2 days. Masks only came in, did they say, on Monday evening that they have to start to wear masks. So, you know, I guess that does bring into the question the effectiveness of relying on the testing. But as Aaron said, you know, right away, they did turn back to Barbados. As soon as they got the positive test, people were back to the room. They then started testing all the crew and passengers again. Once they arrive in Barbados, they'll be tested again. And it appears that the cruise lines actually did a great job keeping the passengers informed. I'm sure there would be a lot of panic and worry if you're a passenger, you've been, you know, told to go back to your room, and that there's a, you know, a positive case. So they did well with intercom messages. They sent letters out. They actually, for the dinner, they put a little menu under the door and people got to choose off a menu. And, you know, me, I'm always worried about the food. So I was glad to hear the food was well taken care of. But, you know, it does. And now, actually, there have been 5 positive cases from that one cruise ship. So it's a small cruise ship to begin with. I think everyone was really hopeful that it was going to be positive. We really want cruising to get back for everybody who depends on it, you know, for a living and for employment and for work, that they really want to get back. So it's so important that we're able to do it successfully.
Yeah, I mean, 53 passengers, 5% would be like 10%. Well, I guess, or 5%. I guess you could say it would be more 5% because it's 55 plus 66 crews. It's about 100 people, 5 people sick.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's crazy though. Like, I think irregardless of the testing, irregardless of you having a positive test, you know, you gotta just assume the person you're interacting with, if they're not in your little family bubble, is positive, right?
Yeah.
Like, I think you just, you know, you can't get lulled into that, oh, everybody's tested, we're all fine, we're not going to wear masks. Well, no, wear your mask, social distance, you know.
Yeah, it's definitely a setback for the cruise industry. I think as we've said, you know, is testing enough? Like, I guess we're going to see that, you know, is it enough? And then, you know, until there's a vaccine or some kind of immunity, is this just going to be the normal? Like, is it just going to be that, especially as larger cruise ships, this was more of a yacht, when you have larger cruise ships going with 500 people to thousands of people, is it going to be assumed that, yep, somebody's going to get COVID? Are you all going to be sent back to your rooms? Or, you know, do you just wear your mask and try and reduce the amount of spread? I don't know.
Yeah, it's definitely, you know, I think it as much as there's a lot of good positive news about things like these new processes and procedures and the testing they're putting on ships and all of this, at the end of the day, it's still a pandemic. So, you know, you got to kind of balance that with whatever your plans are for travel and, you know, understand that it might very well end in something like, you know, a COVID quarantine that you're going to have to deal with, and just be prepared for that. Like, you know, nobody wants that, obviously, but, you know.
Well, and then I guess, like, in hindsight, would masks for 2 days have made a difference? I don't know. You know, we're still hearing a lot of arguments for and against masks in general. But there had been a lot of successful cruising in Europe with masks. So would it have made a difference?
Yeah, I think you just gotta, you know, take every reasonable precaution, and, you know, like it or hate it, putting a mask on isn't necessarily gonna, you know, end your world. You know, you can wear a mask even if it's not effective. What did you lose just wearing a mask?
Yeah, and I guess that's where people will have to decide. If you're somebody who don't believe in masks, then going and doing experiences or traveling, you know, it's not going to be the right time for you. So we'll just have to see some positive things in today's cruise news, and, you know, a little setback. But we'd really love to hear your comments below about all of our stories. What are your thoughts, your opinions? You know, what would you have wanted to change or see happen?
Would you still be willing to cruise on something like the SeaDream, or would you be willing to sign up for one of these test cruises to go through the new processes? And, you know, are you somebody who's interested in, oh, what's going to be new and how is this not going to work? And, you know, help them sort out the right way to do it? Or, you know, what are your thoughts?
So thanks again for watching. We really hope that you enjoyed our video. Please do leave us some comments below. We love being part of the community, and happy travels.